Hi guys, in this video we'll see a basic illustration of NumPy library of Python. So what NumPy is? NumPy is actually numerical Python, it stands for numerical Python. So in our previous videos, in our previous joys, we have seen some part of NumPy. We have been using NumPy a lot of time and to do some tasks, to perform some tasks. But in this video I will show you what else you can do, how basic operations you can perform in NumPy very easily. So what exactly NumPy is used for? Mainly it is used for to perform some matrix operations in Python, and to do it easily you use mostly NumPy library. So array or what's a matrix, mostly matrix we use NumPy. And there are a lot of matrix. If you know linear algebra and matrix theory, then you must know that the applications of matrices are huge, in mostly in image processing and even machine learning and AI. Matrices, the applications are a lot. Mostly if you know matrices and their operations, you can definitely easily cope up with the AI elements and machine learning, so even in deep learning. So for that we use NumPy library a lot. Suppose some of you want to learn machine learning or AI or deep learning, whatever it is, then you need to understand this library, NumPy library, because you will be using this library a lot there. So I'll give you a very basic operations in NumPy library which you can perform. So let's see this. So I'll just import the library. Let me increase this pane. So okay, in most of the videos I keep both of my pane because I like keeping this, but you can when you are working on your programming part or coding part, you can zoom out this part, zoom in this part, and exclude this part, or vice versa. So let's see this. Let me import the NumPy library. So I'll write here import NumPy as my alias will be np here. You can put here, it's a convention, people mostly put np, so you can put any here, you can put x also, but looks nice here. Great. So I'll create an array. How do I create array? I have been creating an array of elements before in Python as a list. So for example, see this console here. Okay, should be 50-50%. Looks good. Okay. So let's see this. Suppose I create a list of name L and my elements are 1, 2, 3. So I'll make a list. List is created like this. 1, 2, 3. Okay, and I'll just run it, and if I see the elements of list, this list L, I'll see 1, 2, 3. So same thing I'll do, but it will create an array. So what's the difference? What you can do when you get an array? As array, you just see it is an object. When you create an array of, let's say, element 1, 2, 3, you can perform a lot of operations through NumPy library, which has been written this in this NumPy library. So you can perform all those operations, a lot of operations there. So we'll make an array of, let's say, all these three elements, 1, 2, 3 first. So let's see, a is equal to np dot array, it will show here. Okay, np dot array, and what are my elements? So let's say 1, 2, 3. So the convention is you pass a list there, list of array, as an argument. So np.array will take an argument. An argument will be my list. Great. Just print this. Let's see what happens. Print A. Let me just run this. You can see 1, 2, 3. Exactly what I was expecting here, I'm getting here. Nothing different. I got an array. Great. Now let me do some other things here with this array. I have the array. Let me just print something. Let me just write it and you will understand what is it exactly. Type of a. Okay. See, showing class numpy dot nd array, n dimensional array. So since this is a one dimensional, it is known as one dimensional array. Let me print something else. One dimensional, why? Because it's just one row and there are three columns. Okay, if you see this as a matrix, there is only one row, which is 1, 2, 3, and there are three columns, first column, second column and third column. So one row, there are three elements, so that's why it's a one dimensional array. Okay, so let me write some more function. Let's say a dot shape. Okay, let me see this. 3, nothing. 3, nothing means it has one row and it has three columns. 3 columns, 1 row. Great. I can print the elements. How am I supposed to get the elements? Same as a list. A dot zero, let's say a one and a two. It will give me the elements as 1, 2, 3. So exactly same as list. How am I supposed to how I retrieve the elements of a list using the indexes? Same analogy is there. Okay, great. I can change the elements also. Exactly, if I want to change the elements of the index, let's say 1 and make it, let's say 6, and just run it, and I can see the array. Okay, 163, same as list, nothing new. Great. What if I want to create a two-dimensional array? Same thing. Let me just delete all these things. I'll change array A as a two-dimensional array. So how I put a two-dimensional list? So one list, inside there will be two lists. List number one will be first row. Okay, so first row is, let's say, 1, 2, 3. Okay, by comma. Second row is a list, which is 4, 5, 6. That's it. Let me just run it to see. Yeah, it's running, so everything is fine. You can see A as, if you run it, array 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is first row, second row as an array. And if you just print the shape of B, not the shape of U, shape of B, shape B dot shape, but you will see B. Sorry, what did I put? It's not B, say sorry. Okay, A dot shape, you will see 2, 3. Okay, so there are two rows and three columns. Great. Awesome. There are many ways through which you can create arrays in. This is one way. Suppose I want to create an array of all zeros. One thing, I will just put a list 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. I can, through loop, I can create a list of zeros and then I will pass this list, that list, or I will just directly use that list, whatever it is. But through NumPy, you can, with one line of code, you can create such array easily. So suppose I want to create an array of zeros, so I'll just, a is equal to np dot set zeros. See, it's coming. I'll just give the dimension I want as array of a matrix of 2×2, 0. Okay, I'll just run it and just see a. See, 0, 0, 0, 0. Great. Or if I want to create an array of ones, np dot ones, so let me give the dimension as again 2, 2, and just run it and see b, give me 1, 1, 1, 1. Great. Okay, or if I want to put some particular number in all the at all the places, let's say, so I can just put np dot full, okay, and let's say I'll give the dimension of array again 2, 2, and what is the that constant, let's say I want to give 6, that's it, and run it, I'll see 6, 6, 6, 6. Awesome, great. Or if you want random numbers also, that too is possible. You'll just put np dot random dot random. So you know random dot random puts from 0 to 1. If you want from if you want integer, then you can put integer values, randint. So I'll just give the dimension as 2, 2, and if you see d, you see some random values from 0 to 1, between 0 to 1 are coming in this array.